Rick's tea this morning.
Took it outside.
It's froze.
On the surface,
yeah, it's like that's sad when you have to drink iced tea. It's just like routine, you know. So it's like you make a glass of iced tea, you go out, you sit down, thing, you do a little walk around the boat.
And the
yeah, that's never ceased. Yeah,
and then call it good.
So we don't need pins.
Yeah, I'm gonna weld something on here. I'm not gonna do that.
There's the boat.
Looking down.
So, yeah. Uh-huh. So if you build a bow roller here, there's your spool.
A lot of people like something across that because they think they're gonna fall out the front of the boat.
Don't go up
and
there.
And then get hit by the
That's my point. It's like you think you're falling.
You put your paint a yellow line across that first step.
little thin yellow line. The thin yellow.
Don't cross fall the line. Off the boat.
Right,
it's about a quarter inch.
A quarter inch is fillable. You just put the weld right up on top of the ankle.
Okay.
Or we could get the bracket and jack and just pull it back down. Whatever you think.
I guess I'll get that Hobart weld down there and weld it off the boat.
Two.
I could almost cut that where half inch chain would go through there, couldn't I?
Yeah.
There we go. That's good.
Yeah, it's definitely self-launching. That'll launch me too.
Yeah, if that was a roller, it would go.
Give it a little push. There it is. Fantastic boat right there, hadn't it?
Yep.
That's not good.
It's like we got to go out further beyond the bow.
Yeah.
Keep that from happening.
Usually they're quite a ways beyond the bow.
Well, that's why.
It's close.
Huh.
It goes outside.
Oh, did it?
Yeah.
Well, it might, but it might not.
Yeah, it'll be all right.
Okay.
Wasn't enough will for that.
Oh! Oh my goodness.
Well, you know, it's all right, really.
Yeah.
That's really the fulcrum right there anyway. Let's just try and pull it up over that. Much easier. I mean, it's nothing now.
It's home. 2 inches.
2 inches away.
Yeah.
Yeah. Huh. When we pull it up, it works fine.
Yeah. Try releasing it and see if it stays.
All right. Yeah.
Good 4 inches now. Yeah, now it's coming in. Okay, I got about 3.5 inches. Alright, now I'm hungry.
Good.
In case you're wondering, our Christmas tree is made out of quarter-inch steel, of course, with pieces of slag glass that came out of foundries in Arkansas.
This is our second design. Let me try it out.
I think most of the weight's down below.
All right.
It's somewhat welding.
Yeah.
Welding in there. This is the last day we have DC here, and he's been a pleasure to have because he has a sailboat and he does a lot of anchoring out. So we designed the bow roller, and I think we got a good design once we work the details out.
That,
yeah.
If that goes,
well, there's a better bolt up here than that one.
That's the only bolt I've seen up here.
You could weld it on there.
Yeah, we could. It'd gotta do it without any tension on it.
That's what I'm thinking too. Heating it up doesn't sound like a great idea.
I guess we need this here.
This is weigh anchor test number one. Yeah.
Yeah, if it was a roller, it'd be different.
If it, yeah, absolutely.
Need another roller to keep the chain lower down to the deck because it's touching it right here.
Yeah.
That's what has it at this elevation. If we raise it up, the chain's going to keep coming up until it's in contact with this one. It's almost like we need to lower this one down. If we lower that one down to here?
No, because the end of it's got to go underneath it.
Yeah, that's right. Okay, but we're going to need another roller. We need one here to keep this chain at this elevation, then we need to bring this up higher.
Okay.
And that will, because right now I got it tied to the cabin top.
Yeah.
But on the spool, it could actually be up higher than that. See if I push down on it. Yeah, so see, it would be like that.
Yeah.
And that makes it go in.
Yeah.
But it, as soon as I let go.
Yeah, yeah.
Go ahead and back off the winch. Hold on. There. Yeah, see?
Yeah.
Once it catches it, it's fine. But we need another roller here and make this pin higher up. I like this thing. It's nice.
Yeah.
And then we need a piece of plastic out here on the deck or else extend this whole rigmarole out.
See, and that little piece is called a chain stopper, and that's really part of the design that I love because that's what's going to hold the anchor. Then you could do what you like with the winch or the chain behind it. So what we're going to do is we're going to extend this on out so that locker's here, and we'll put a pulley behind it so that it controls the height of the chain, and we ought to be good.
Yeah.
A little bit of bevel down there at the bottom.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, we didn't put it in very straight.
Okay, the backward anchor test. Crank away.
Why'd we have to let it down so far? Oh, it's a good test. That's yeah.
It's wiggling. Oh, it's getting tired.
Oh, look at that.
Ha! Cool. Yeah, that rotated it. Well, I sure don't think we need any less than 4 inches in there. I'm thinking 4.5 now. Just that last bit. You know, if we locked it off right there.
Yeah.
You could stop there for the day.
Yeah.
See, that needs to be higher.
Yeah.
We know that.
Yeah.
But this is the other feature is a keeper pin. And it probably could share that hole. So I'm gonna go back and forth a little bit, but if it had its own hole,
it wouldn't shuffle.
It wouldn't shift as much.
Yeah. But this pin could be as thick as the hole is wide.
Yeah, that's true too.
You know,
that wouldn't hurt anything.
Yeah. Yep, nothing too strong ever broke.
That's right.
See, the problem now is that spool is not as wide as I thought it was. The capstans stick out a long way. But we gotta get it around the mast. Now I'm thinking of losing this capstan and offsetting it to this side.
So you think of a pipe goes down and a chain locker below?
Yeah.
Yeah. And I'm not crazy about that idea. I could lose this capstan and put a chain spool where this capstan is.
Yeah.
I mean a cable spool out here. And leave that center one nothing.
Yeah.
Or for a spare road.
Yeah.
Yeah, that works.
I like that.
Yeah, me too.
All right. So it would have to be, the hole would have to be below wherever the tender's gonna be.
Yeah, but.
All right. How wide is that, the tender?
The tender's bottom could be here.
Okay. It has to be like 1.5 times whatever size line you're going to pull through there.
Yeah, I'm thinking 3 inches.
Yeah.
That's where the pipe comes through, and there's a Samson post thing here because it goes through this deck and then it goes on down, ties to the transom too, which is about 8 inches below, and that gives it a lot more strength. We can even gusset it back this direction underneath this deck. That's for tying on lines for towing. The mizzen mast, we're on the aft deck, so it's the mizzen mast, comes down through here. There's a toilet that'll be over on this side that'll come out to the floor. A shower on that end. A drain, what we call our freeing ports, cut through on that side. And then the same thing over here, a locker and another freeing port. So anyway, that's a refinement of our previous ideas. I like it.
It's gonna work right up to when we gotta go to the airport.
Well, we're in the pilot house, and those last wells that DC put in are right down here on the floor. You can see where they burned into the plate. And boy, I tell you what, that did the job, because this used to flex just a little bit. Now I don't feel that anymore, so.
Okay, I got a special announcement for you. You gotta go look at Nick over at the Renegade Show. He did a video, an interview with me, and we talk about the kind of thing that Seeker's gonna be doing out there on the water. He's got it all planned out, and I won't spoil it here, but I'll put that link up over in the corner. That's for Nick. Well, actually, it takes you to my site, but it'll get you to his video, okay? Go look at that. Check it out.
Hey, everybody, meet Clyde. Clyde's going to be with us for a couple weeks, and he's already been welding.
All this done back here?
Well, that feels nice. You did a nice job grinding that.
Yeah, beautiful.
A beater.
Hammer.
I don't know what my sledges are right now.
How you doing?
This is so cool. I've been at work and Joel's been here working on the boat today. I'll put a couple hours in. And we gotta admire Clyde's truck down there. It's actually a Corvette with a truck body on it.
Yeah. Clyde and Bart are off to Coffeyville, Kansas to pick up some lumber for Bart's home.
How you cut that angle? Oh, the flat bar, yeah. Cool.
You wanna go down with it?
Yeah. Is there anything that's gonna be below that would be obstructing with?
Tanks, but okay. Probably not.
I could put a 45 on the bottom of it.
Yeah, do that.
Yeah. Well, you got a lot of nails and screws to pull, but
I got a lot of nails and screws.
That's a good pile of lumber.
Yes,
well, you got enough insulation for sure for your whole tiny home.
Frick, yeah.
$70 for a whole pickup load of stuff. Nicely done.
Okay, it's got to be right because we've done it 3 times now. But the trick was using this big, what is that, 4x4 frame along with the 2x2 frame, and that helped a lot. So if anybody doing this in the future, that's the best idea I got.
Some people come to work on the boat are very eager. It's very, very inspiring, but Clyde is up here. He's still vacuuming. I left to go out with dinner with a friend, and I'm back. So it was a long dinner, and he's still vacuuming. Thunderstorms Sunday.
Wow.
You believe that? 67 degrees.
long as you need to cover the plasma torch up down below, we'll be done.
A little of this anti-spatter grease rubbed down inside of the nut keeps the spatter from sticking inside so badly.
Well, these are going to be supports to take the end of the rudder piston, and this is the pin that holds that big hydraulic cylinder on. But we're just going to make up a jig so that we can do that spacing with something much lighter weight in our hands.
Locking cords we got. It worked. Sexy job, but somebody's got to do it. Those holes down there have served as well as drain holes and other things. They're actually the holes we cut in the steel when we first started lifting the plate over and back.
That's the whole thing in the air. That's a lot easier.
And, today it's Joel's honor to close up the last four of them in the boat. Two up here, two in the engine room.
That looks good. Okay.
Hold them on upside down.
Okay, it doesn't smell like diesel in here, that's good.
Where's he at, Duke? Oh, he's down there, isn't he? Yeah, he is.
Seal the rudder.
Got a little weld distortion in these pieces, so what Joel's doing is he's heating up a little triangle, and that now that they're actually high on this wall and they're pushed down underneath their pads on the side, so since they got some force on them, we're heating them up so they'll stay in that position.
So you see that triangle he's heating, it's wider on the bottom and pointy at the top.
See, there's the first one that's been heated. We did two triangles but only used one of them. You know, if it doesn't work with one, you come back and do another one. And that got it fixed, so now this is straightened out. There's no pressure here anymore.
Hey, you can watch it. Okay, there you go.
Put a hatch in back here so we can work on that rudder post, so they're working on drilling holes for it. And we cut two fretting ports for back here too. We just got to put the outside edges on them. And the neighbors are prepping Christmas dinner across the way. Two fresh goats today. Cabrito.
Good. Good.
But this crane actually has the ability to pitch up at 75 degrees, so it can lift the load within a foot or, well, no, within 2 feet of itself. And the engine out here is at 15 feet, and that's like, what is that, 1850, somewhere in that range. If everything's working great, it can pick up almost 2,000 pounds.
There you go.
I wonder if we could just use 3-inch flat bar, make our box out of it. I got quarter flat. Quarter's not heavy enough, though.
Oh, you know what I got? How about angle iron?
Cut a plate and butt weld it inside of the angle iron to make our box. We're gonna leave it open in the middle anyway. Why the hell are we gonna have to do that? We just use. I got 3-inch by 3-inch, 3/8-inch thick angle. We'll just weld an angle iron box around it. And that gives us our lip for the bolts. The bolts sit right on the edge, don't they?
Yeah. That's toward the crane.
It'll catch one side. Like as long as you.
Yeah, and the other bolts underneath that. Yeah. What are you doing down there?
I wanted to make a gasket ditch. Okay, it's fitting in there now.
Leave them off. There you go.
Hey, these two look okay. What you got?
No, you just...
Sands from Fort Worth, Texas. Abby Durham.
Look, they made it square.
Imagine that.
There we go.
There we go.
There we go.
I'm going.
Well, there's a hole for a crane right up in there when it comes over this side a little bit too. And we're gonna put a couple more frames, maybe one or two. Joel hadn't decided yet. To stiffen this up over into the front wall of the countertop. And there's always going to be somebody that worries. God, there's always somebody that worries about everything, but that's a hell of a lot more steel structure than the truck had that I took it off of. Okay.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
That looks great.
That makes a drip edge, so the water, when it runs out, it doesn't curl back underneath. It gives it a reason to drip off out of there on the edge.
Put these holes up here.
Oh, okay.
So it's got its own air dryer system.
Yeah,
cool.
Cold air.
Cool. Corvette.
This is 16.
When did you do this? How long you've had this?
It's been 14 years.
Was the Corvette a Corvette before? Or was it smashed up?
It's a 95 Corvette.
And the Corvette got smashed up, so you took
it? Yeah, it was hitting the rear real hard.
Mm.
Destroyed the whole back end of the Corvette.
Right. Oh, busted.
Well, I actually like Corvettes and trucks. Busted.
An old Hypertherm 1000 is a 60-amp plasma cutter, and that is 1 inch of steel. Hypertherm says the maximum cut is 3/4 inch, but they're just being polite, unlike Chinese tools, which you need to divide by two. But that is a little bit of slag on the bottom, but that's 1 inch, and boy, that is a beautiful cut for 1 inch of steel. And the trick is just go ahead and change out the consumables. Use a new electrode tip and nozzle before you start.
And no, Hypertherm did not give me the torch for free or anything like that, or I'm not working for them. And just to level the field, they make a torch height controller, which is an absolutely overpriced piece of shit, okay? So there you go. Now we're stick welding this because you can't always get a MIG welder into those tight places up there, and stick works great for that.
Look at that. Right back in place.
Right back in place.
You're in?
I'm in.
Yeah, that's perfect.
Extremely well done.
There you go. Now that has three shackle holes in the back and one in the forward piece of it. And all we need is a shackle with like an inch and a quarter. That's the size of the hole pin in it. And then we can put another one up on the other corner. We can put a bridle up there. We can put a four-point anchoring system up there. We can do all kinds of things.
Now we're taking a brace out here because what we decided on is sliding doors for the pilot house here. That one up there will be sliding too. So. One thing, take away.
Horizontal beat. And there is the top joint. I think that's pretty damn good for being so freaking uncomfortable.
Yeah, it's not gonna win any beauty contest, but it's gonna hold.